Seven bells, it's time for...
The S.S.Popeye sails again with a full cargo of cartoon fun and your pals Cooky and the Captain. Brought to you by your favorite, the self-service Hill Brothers Shoe Store. Now, where's Cooky?
Here I am, Captain. Ah, say.
How about that, huh?
You're all set now for your jockey lessons?
Well, I feel kind of funny in these jockey pants, Captain.
Oh, well, they're not complete yet. See? You see my riding pants?
Mm-hmm.
Actually, I don't do any horseback riding, but this is what all trainers wear. You got your riding crop?
Yes, sir. What do you do with that?
Well, that's in case, like, after you've been riding a horse and you get off the horse and somebody comes up and says, say, you're a terrible rider, you can say, en garde! Get that up there, pal. See?
That's not what you do with that, Captain. That's what you kind of give the horse a little pat with to make him go faster.
You would whip a horse?
Oh, no, not me, Captain. I mean, you don't whip him with this.
You better not whip that horse. I'll give you a rap.
See that little piece of leather on the end there?
Yeah.
You just kind of go like that, you see?
Oh, so it doesn't hurt him.
No,
you just go like that.
Yeah.
Huh? Okay, pal. Now, the reason that you don't think you look
keep
so
that
hot...
up and you'll lose a partner.
The reason you don't think you look so hot, and you don't, is because you don't have all of your riding costume on yet.
I know, I need some boots. All jockeys have boots, Captain.
We're doing away with boots. Get away with boots. We're using leggings.
That's World War I stuff.
Certainly. Certainly. That's boy, how you think we got through the muck and mire of those trenches? You'll be able to use
Were you at Chateau Terry?
No. I never drink that stuff. Anyway, listen.
That was a place, Captain.
Oh, no, I wasn't there either. Anyway, I'll show you how to wrap these on in just a moment. And then, see, that's the way you can get your feet in the stirrups and everything.
Oh, okay.
And then we'll start our riding with
All right, well, let's watch a cartoon first, huh?
Okay, help me out
okay.
do this.
Say, you know what day this is, don't you? It's New Year's Eve, and it's time for you to make your New Year's resolutions. Look here, these are all my New Year's resolutions there. I got kind of carried away, didn't I, huh? There's one real important New Year's resolution for 1961, and I'm going to stick to it. I resolve to buy my shoes at Hill Brothers. And, mateys, I think that'd be a good resolution for you and Mom and Dad and brother and sister and the whole family. Because, you know, if you buy all your shoes at Hill Brothers during 1961, you know, you'll be getting wonderful selections, many different styles, and Mom will find that she'll really have saved a lot of money in the end of the year, too. Shopping's so much fun at Hill Brothers, too. You can save time as well as money by shopping the self-service way. And there are twofers, all children's shoes, the large size 3, 2 pairs for $5, and twofers for Mom, too. She can get beautiful flats and loafers for herself, 2 pairs for $5. So remember, Hill Brothers, headquarters for fine shoes in 1961. Head for the hills, won't you? There are 9 convenient Hill Brothers stores in the St. Louis area. In fact, there's one right near your home. So remember, head for the hills. Captain, sir, this leg in here that you put on that doesn't do just right.
Training book.
See, this the horse training book here?
Yeah, let me get the rest of these.
Oh, yes.
Well, I'm telling you, you're looking more and more like a jockey all the time, pal.
The big book of horses.
I suppose you are probably wondering why I entered our horse. Why I entered our horse in a race so soon.
Well, yes, I kind of wondered that, Captain.
Well, the race is
since you haven't trained the horse.
Well, I figure, why wait around? I know that with just a little bit of reading and preparation, I will be the world's champion trainer. And when I get through with you, pal, you'll be the world's champion jockey. And then we can...
With our horse,
Fiedelbaum, that we won, Fiedelbaum is bound to be a very fast, speedy horse. So we can't lose, and we'll win that race. So you just listen attention to me.
Aren't you going to have Eddie R. Carroll come in? You're just...
I did away with all those. I'm having you come in there, pal, because I know I can train you, okay?
Okay, Captain.
Okay.
I'm ready for anything.
First thing you have to do is learn something about the horse. Now, you hold this book right there.
Okay.
Now, there you see a picture of a typical thoroughbred right there.
That's a horse.
That's a horse, certainly. Don't you even know a horse when you see one? And here, you will see that the various parts of the horse are named. so that you can identify the horse. You know, like, for instance, see what that is? That says that's the tail. Now, you didn't know that, did you? That's the tail right there. Right up here is the head. Now, you see that?
I know the head from the tail.
All right. Now, right here is a very important part. This is called the croup. And when a horse gets the croup, boy, that's something. He coughs and coughs. And you got to be careful for this spot. That spot doesn't get cold, so he won't get the croup.
Captain, I don't believe that's what that means. I think that's why they call that little stick you got in your hand a croup, because that's where you apply it, you see.
But in other words, you just go and give him a little touch there so he doesn't get the croup, huh?
Give him a little touch, but no,
yeah.
Captain.
Well, that makes sense. Okay, now, do's and don'ts in horsemanship.
Okay.
Don't let your horse start until you are completely in the saddle, then give him the signal, right?
Well, that makes sense.
Okay.
Yes.
Don't rush to the front and constantly try to be the leader when riding with other riders. That's silly. That is silly. I want you to out there this afternoon in that race to rush to the front and be the leader over all those riders, right?
All right.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now, don't feed your horse while his tack is being put on. Why anybody want to put a tack on a horse? That's kind of cruel.
Captain, the tack is the bridle and saddle and...
Oh, his equipment.
Yes.
Okay. And finally, don't fall in love with your horse. You like horses?
I don't like them that well.
Well, it says don't fall in love with horses, because if you do, you'll never want to sell or exchange him for a better one.
Well, we don't want to sell Fetal Bomb anyway, do we?
Well, that's right. Besides, I kind of like Fetal Bomb.
Yeah. You love Fetal Bomb?
Yeah, I think that's a pretty lousy book after all. Forget all that stuff. I'll show you some real things how to ride in just a moment. Did you go get the imitation rider?
No, I'll go get it, Captain.
Okay, go get that.
Cartoon.
And I'll teach you how to do that.
Okay.
And they wanted you to stay home. Had a good. Break it down.
Step right up here, kids. I want to show you the greatest little sale in the world. This is the Rain or Shine sale at Hill Brothers. That's how they'd say it in a carnival, huh? But I'll just tell you that the Rain or Shine sale is going on right now, and I'll tell you what it means. It means that you can buy a pair of these wonderful rubber boots for yourself to protect your feet from the rain and snow and slush this winter, and a pair of children's shoes to large size 3 and pay only $5 for both of them. That's right. You get a pair of rubber boots and a pair of children's shoes to large size 3 and pay only $5 for both pairs. And say, there are all sizes, too, for the whole family of boots at Hill Brothers. So you can get boots for Mom and boots for Dad and big brother or sister. And, of course, don't forget boots and shoes for yourself, huh? All kinds of shoes, boots, and overshoes for the whole family at Hill Brothers. So head for the hills. The Hill Brothers self-service shoe store. There are 9 stores in the St. Louis area. Won't you head for one right away?
Get up there, Prancer and Dancer and Hi-Yo Silver. And that's the way you use this as a caller, riding croup. Crop. Crop? Crop, yes. There's a riding crop. Boy, and you see, I won this horse on a contest. And we heard the contest on the radio, the winners announced yesterday, and I won this horse. The name of the horse is Fetal Bomb. I haven't seen a horse yet, but I know that he'll probably be a champion racehorse. So right away, I entered him in a race that's going to be run this afternoon. And who do you think is going to be my jockey?
Cooky.
Right. And I'm training him, and he'll be all trained by this afternoon. And old Fetal Bomb will win that race, boy. He can't lose. These are mates right here. Let's find out who they are. This is our first mate. What's your name, pal?
Larry.
Larry? How old are you, Larry?
He's 4.
4 years old for Larry? Okay, let's see what we have.
He always says a higher number because he thinks he's...
Larry, you like... wait a minute. How old is the third mate? How old are you, pal?
5.
Well, Larry, how about for you a Popeye numbered pencil coloring set? Hey, and a brand new TV guide. And boy, this TV guide is complete bowl game lineups. If you like football, too. That's for television. Second mate, what's your name?
Christine.
Okay, Christine. 3 chipmunks paint and crayon set and a brand new TV guide for you.
Oh, thank you.
And third mate, what's your name? Third mate, you like airplanes?
Yeah.
Well, here's a kit that has two airplane models in it. Two of them. You can put those together, and there's your new TV guide. You'll have lots of fun. Okay.
Captain, remind them we won't be on Monday.
No, that's right. We won't be on Monday because of the special bowl games, but we'll tell you more about that later. Right now, Cookie, I'm going to start the riding lessons right now while we watch a cartoon.
Okay.
Dearest and poorest friend. What did I do wrong?
Say, I want to remind you now that during 1961, to keep that resolution we talked about, what was that resolution? To buy all your shoes where? Hill Brothers, that's right. Because, boy, you really save money when you shop at Hill Brothers for your shoes. And Mom saves lots of money, too, on her shoes and Dad's shoes. Shoes for the whole family. So remember to head for the hill. I want to remind you now that there are 9 great Hill Brothers shoe stores in the St. Louis area. That means there's a Hill Brothers shoe store right near where you live. And on the Illinois side, too. In East St. Louis, you'll find one. And in Alton, East Alton, Illinois. So remember to head for the hills and shop the self-service way and save. Hill Brothers, self-service shoe stores. 9 in the St. Louis area to better serve you. So remember, serve yourself and save, and head for the hills. What are you doing, Captain? Huh? What are you whipping that barrel for?
I was taking a little canter while you were doing that commercial. Now, this view may look like a barrel to you. Boy, his withers are getting kind of bad there, aren't they? Or is that the croup?
That's the croup. Okay, right
now,
there.
This looks like a barrel
that's
to you, but it's actually...
That's a head.
This is to practice riding on Fiedelbaum, because he's going to be delivered this afternoon right at the track.
That's
and you meet
the
him
size of Fiedelbaum, too.
Certainly. All right, hot ride board there. First, you mount. That's right. Now, you got the reins?
I got the reins,
Got your riding croup?
I got my riding
croup. Let me see you apply the riding croup.
Isn't this silly?
No, you have to learn how to ride. Apply the riding croup. Okay, now... We'll figure that this is the race. And they're off! And they're going to the first quarter. First quarter, and down they go. And it looks like Fiedelbaum and Cookie are in the front. They get to the half, and they're continuing down the track, and it's still Fiedelbaum and Cookie going under the front. They get down to the three-quarter pole, and it's Fiedelbaum and Cookie, man. And they're still going. Now they're coming down to the wire.
Come on,
Fiedelbaum and Cookie are still in front. They're coming down to the wire with just 30 seconds to go. And it looks like Fiedelbaum and Cookie's going to win. How do you expect to win a race if you fall off the horse? You're going to do better than that if you're going to win that race.
Gee whiz, don't go away, kids. We'll be right back with the second half of our cruise and remind you that the first half was brought to you by Hill Brothers Self-Service Shoe Store. Don't go away.
Hey, boy, how about that, huh?
Hey,
Cookie. Fell off the barrel.
Well, Captain, I told you I wasn't a jockey. You're supposed to be the world's champion trainer and train me how to ride.
I got to get you ready for that big race this afternoon. Fiedelbaum's going to win.
That's right. Boy, that'll be fun, riding a horse. Did you ever ride a horse, huh?
Yeah!
I never did ride a racehorse. Well, let's see how this is going to be. Let's watch another cartoon right now.
1, 2, 1, 2. Captain. 1, 2, and halt.
Captain, I'm getting a little tired.
Oh, are you tired, pal?
Yeah.
Well, here, rest for a minute. I don't want you overdue.
Oh, boy.
Boy.
Captain.
Feel good?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let's get back to those exercises. That's enough rest for anybody. Oh. That'll get you down 46 pounds for that race field bomb. Oh, this is so fatiguing on me, you have no idea.
1, 2. 1, 2.
I get awful tired. Keep those exercises. 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to take you direct to the scene of the big Run for the Roses, the annual race that has everyone talking. Now, direct to the track and your track announcer.
Hey, It's a beautiful day for the race. Stooge Hand is the favorite today. Assault is in there. Dog Biscuit is 3-1. Safety Pin has been scratched. And at 20-1, Beetle Bomb. Now the horses are approaching the starting gate, and there they go! And it's Stooge Hand going to the front. Cabbage is second on the rail. Beautiful Linda is third by a length. And Beetle Bomb. Around the first turn, Stooge Hand is still in front. Cabbage is second by a head.
Cabbage by a head!
Beautiful Linda is third. And Beetle Bomb. Into the back stretch, Dog Biscuit is now leading the pack. Lady Evelyn is second, very close. Banana is coming up through the bunch.
Banana coming up through the bunch!
And Beetle Bomb. At the half, Stooge Hand still out in front. Apartment House is second with plenty of room. Assault is passing Battery.
Assault Battery!
Notary Soul Jack is fourth. And in last place by 10 lengths, I believe it is, yes, it is Beetle Bomb. Around the turn, heading for home. It's Stooge Hand and Dog Biscuit and Girdle in the stretch. Flying Sylvester is third, and Mother-in-Law nagging in the rear. And now they come down to the wire, and it's number one, and now number two, and it's very close. It'll either be a photo finish or an oil painting. And now Lewis leads with a left, and Lewis is in there slugging, and it's a battle, and now they're tearing hair. There's hair all over the ring, there's hair all over the place. I don't know whose hair it is. It's mine. And there goes the winner!
We won. Field Bomb won. We won the race.
Captain, wake up. We won a race, Pat. Cap, you've been asleep.
Hey, we just got the package in the mail and the picture of Field Bomb came.
Oh, let me see that thoroughbred race horse.
Captain. Captain, that's not a thoroughbred race horse.
Gee whiz, Captain. No big race for us, huh? Well, it was fun training with you, pal. Yeah, Captain, cheer up. Cheer up, Captain.
I'm gonna go trade these riding pants for a brand new uniform.
No more horse race. Oh! Captain, we'll see you Monday, kids. Bye-bye.
The S.S. Popeye sails every day at 4 o'clock on Channel 4. Join us at 11:30 next Saturday. The Admiral today was Robert Schnorr. ¶¶